Now, in this problem, R1 is 5 ohm, R2 is equal to 10 ohm, and R3 is equal to 30 ohm. And this is 12 volt battery is connected across these three. These three are connected in parallel because the edges of this first resistance is connected across the same battery. Second also is connected across the same, and third also it's connected between positive and negative of the given battery. Therefore, these three are connected in parallel. What's the beauty of parallel circuit? It is the current can be calculated directly without calculating the net resistance. So I1 is equal to the potential according to Ohm's law, V by R. So V by R1. So it's going to be 12 by 5, which gives you the answer as 2.4 ampere. Next, I2, 12 by 10, because R2 is 10, therefore it is 1.2, and I3 is 12 by 30, which will give you 0.4 ampere. So if you want to calculate the total current, (2.4 + 1.2 + 0.4) is 4 ampere. Now, if you want to calculate the net resistance, there are two methods. Either you can go like this, 1 by resistance parallel is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So, here 1 by 5, 1 by 10 and 1 by 30. 30 is the LCM, 5 6s are, 10 3s are, and 30 1s are. So 6 plus 3 9, 9 plus 1 10 by 30, which is 1 by 3, but it is RP reciprocal. Therefore, RP must be equal to 3 ohm. The same thing can be calculated in a different method. What is that different method? Net resistance is always equal to potential net by current net or net current. Total potential difference by total current. Total potential difference is 12 volt. Total current is 4 amperes. Therefore, 3 ohm. Either you can calculate like this, or you can directly calculate like this. In this question, we have to connect an ammeter to measure the current across 12 ohm. We know that if the resistors are connected in series, you can connect this ammeter anywhere. You can connect here, you can connect here, you can connect here, you can connect here, anywhere you can connect. So that, why actually we can connect like that? Because the current passing through the elements that are connected in series is same. So, and which is also equal to the current drawn through the battery. So this ammeter can be connected anywhere. Now, we have to connect the voltmeter because we wanted to know the drop across 12 ohm resistor. So this voltmeter must be connected here only. And now we have to write voltmeter and ammeter. To know the current, I is equal to net voltage by net resistance. So series, in series we have to add. So 6 by 25 ampere. This is the current. Now this can be furtherly simplified, of course. Now what is the potential difference? V across 6 ohm. I'm sorry. V across 12 ohm. That is equal to current into resistance. V is equal to IR. So current is same, 6 by 25 times 12. That is 72 by 25 volt. In this problem, we have to calculate the total resistance. So total resistance, first these two are in parallel, and in turn this effective resistance of these two resistors is connected with the effective resistance of these three in series, because it is followed. Suppose if I replace this diagram, so this is R 10 and 40 effective resistance, and then it is 12 volt. Then if this is effective resistance of 30, 20 and 60, these three are connected in parallel again, and this is ammeter. So to calculate the net resistance, I have to take this effective resistance. So R effective, that is 1 by R, let's say that it is R1. 1 by R1 is equal to 1 by 10 plus 1 by, because R1 he has given, that is 1 by R dash. 1 by 10 plus 1 by 40, which 4 plus 1, therefore this is 5 by 40, that is 1 by 8, R dash is equal to 8. Similarly, let this be R double dash. So 1 by R double dash is equal to 1 by 30, 1 by 20 plus 1 by 60. So 60 is the LCM. Now 2 plus 3 plus 1. So that is 6 by 60, which is 1 by 10. Therefore, R double dash is equal to 10 ohm. Therefore, net resistance of the circuit as these two are connected in series, 8 plus 10, that is R dash plus R double dash, because this is connected in series, that is 18 ohm. Now to calculate the current, again we use the same V net by R net. So V net means 12, R net is 18, so this is 2 by 3, which gives 0.666, and so on, or otherwise by simplifying 0.67 ampere. To calculate the net resistance in the two problems, these two are connected in parallel, these three are connected in parallel. So first let us do this one. 1 by R is equal to 1 by 1 plus 1 by 10 to the power of 6. So 10 to the power of 6 plus 1 divided by 10 to the power of 6. So here 10 to the power of 6 means 10 lakhs. 10 lakhs plus 1. Whether you add 1 to 10 lakhs or do not add, hardly it matters. Therefore, we can approximately take this as 10 to the power of 6. This is also 10 to the power of 6. Therefore, it is equal to 1. 1 by 1. Therefore, R is equal to 1 ohm. If you actually calculate how much you will get, 10 to the power of 6 means 1 followed by 6 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then this 1 is to be added, divided by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is almost equal to 1. So, when compared to 10 to the power of 6, 1 is very small. So, you need not add it. And directly we can write. So, 1 ohm is the answer for this one. Now, next thing. Suppose, here in this case, 1 by R is equal to 1 by 1. Plus 1 by 10 to the power of 3 plus 1 by 10 to the power of 6. In this case, 10 to the power of 6 is again LCM. 10 to the power of 6 will come here. 10 to the power of 3 and here it is 1. So, here again, it is 10 lakhs, this is 1000, this is 1. So, 10 lakhs, 1001 divided by 10 lakhs. So, it is also, when compared to 10 to the power of 6, we can even neglect this 1001. Suppose if you do not want to neglect this 10 cube, then 1 can be neglected, of course. When compared to 10 to the power of 6, it's very less. So, in this case, 10 to the power of 6 plus 10 to the power of 3 by 10 to the power of 6 again. Now, R is equal to 10 to the power of 6 and I can take 10 to the power of 3 because I am taking the reciprocal of it. So, 1000 plus 1. So, it is approximately 10 to the power of 6. This is 10 cube. If I again consider this 1 is neglected, again one more 10 cube. So, ultimately, it is 1 ohm. So, when a very big number and a very small number is added, always the result will be nearer to the biggest number only. So, here to add 1 or 1000 to 10 lakhs, it's very less. Even at this step also, you can neglect this 1001. Directly you can say the answer as 1 ohm. In this problem, the given condition is that here three are connected, lamp, toaster and water filter across the 220 volt source. And in the second situation, electrical iron is connected across the same source. The condition is that what should be the resistance if it draws the same current? So, to get the same current, the net resistance must be equal to this one. Therefore, resistance of iron, electrical iron, must be equal to what? Net resistance. Net R of 100, 50 and 500. But these are connected in parallel. So therefore 1 by R is equal to 1 by 100 plus 1 by 50 plus 1 by 500. The LCM is 500. Here it is 5 plus 10 plus 1. 16 by 500 R, the resistance is 500 by 16 ohms. It can be furtherly simplified, of course. Now, the second bit, he is asking the current even. So, current is equal to net potential by net resistance. That is equal to 220 by 500 into 16. So this 0 can be cancelled. 2 11s, 2 25s, 16 ones are 16, 16 ones are 16, 117 by 25 ampere.